Hello student, today we are going to start with the new lesson. The lesson name is Separation of Substances. What is the new lesson we are going to study today? Today we are going to discuss with the new lesson, that is Separation of Substances. Why we are going to separate the substances? Is there any necessary to separate the substances? Okay, now we are going to take so many examples. Okay, now we are going to take so many examples to know about the separation of the substances. The first example what I am going to taking is, after making the tea, okay, what are the raw materials used to make the tea? Milk, tea powder, sugar, right? These are the three important substances required for the preparation of the tea. After preparing the tea, what we are going to do? We are going to filter the substance, right? We are going to filter the solid substance in the one pot, and we are going to take the liquid substances. What is the tea we are going to drinking? That tea we taken as a liquid substances. Therefore, the large solid substances that present in the tea we are going to separate. This is also the one example for the separation of the substances. Okay, another substance, another example we are going to take now. If you see the rice, okay, if you see the grain of the rice, if that in the grain of the rice, if you have the some of the rock, some of the mud, if that is present in that one, means what we are going to do? We are going to separate that also, right? We are going to separate the rice in the one side and also the mud, the rocky part in the separate. Why we are going to separate the substances? What is the meaning of the separation? What is the definition you can give for the separation? If you see, what is the meaning of the separation means the dividing of substances. The separation, the dividing of substances with their respective characters, we know as the separation. What is separation? Dividing of a substances with their respective characters. That means if you see in the tea here, the solid tea pot, okay, the tea leaves are separated, the whole tea leaves are separated. If you see in the rice, mud and rock, here the rock and mud is separated, are divided from that rice. Therefore, what is separation? If you see, separation means dividing of the substances with their respective character, that we call it as an separation. Understood? I also explain some of the examples for the separation. After seeing some of the examples of separation, now we are going to see some of the methods of separation. Now we are going to discuss with some of the methods of separation. If you see some of the methods of separation, in this concept we are going to discuss with the four important methods of separation. What are the four important methods of separation we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss with the four important method of separation, that is, first one is hand picking, second one is threshing, third one is winnowing, and the last one is sieving. What are the four important methods of separation? So many other methods is also there, but now for this class, that means for your sixth standard, we are going to discuss about these four methods of suppression. What are the four important methods of suppression? One is hand picking, threshing, winnowing and sieving. Now we are going to discuss one by one. Okay, now we are going to discuss with one by one. First, we are going to discuss with hand picking method of suppression. Okay, if you see in this method, that means in the hand picking, okay, in this method of suppression, here we are going to pick the substances with the use of the hands. Therefore, in this method, the one substance should be in the small quantity and another substance should be in the large quantity. That means one substance should be in the small size and another substance should be in the large size. Then only this hand picking method takes place. Example for this hand picking. I said that if you see in the grains or if you see in the rice, okay, if you see in the wheat or everything, if any small rock particles are present or if any some of the stones are present in that substances, means we are going to pick that stone with the use of the hand only, right? We are going to pick that stones from that substances easily through the hands. This type of the separation of the substances we call it as an hand picking method. What is the hand picking method? It is the method of separation in which the substance are separated by using hand. What is hand picking method? Hand picking method is the method of separation of the substances with the use of the hand and also with the use of the human being. This is all about the hand picking separation. Okay, after studying with the hand picking separation, now we are going to discuss with the second method of separation. What is the second method of separation? The second method of separation we are going to discuss about threshing. T-H-R-E-S-H-I-N-G. Threshing. What is this threshing? Okay, if you go for the agricultural field or you are the kids of the farmer, you know that. Okay, what is this threshing means? After growing of the crop, the crop is get cutted and put into the some places for drying, right? After growing of the crops, after the full yield of the crop will come, the crops are cutted and put into the some place for the drying. After drying, they are going to take some amount of the crop and they are going to beat that crops with the use of the any strong substance. What they are going to do? After the drying of that crop, they are going to take some amount of the crop and they are going to beat it. They are going to beat that crop. They are going to beat that crop with the strong surface. After beating, what happened? The substance, okay, that food crop, what are the crop are like wheat, rice, like that. That crop is separated from the waste. Okay, that crop is separated from the waste of the that grass or everything like that. Okay, threshing means beating of the crop with the strong surface. Beating of the crop with the strong surface, that we call it as an threshing. Threshing can be seen in the agricultural field. This is the second method of separation. In the first method of separation, we don't want to use any physical force to that, right? For the hand picking, we can easily pick that one. Small amount of force is required. But if you see in the threshing, large amount of the physical strength is required. Why we want so much of physical strength? We are going to beaten the substance to separate. In the threshing process, we are going to beaten the substance to get separated. This is of the threshing. And the next one is winnowing. The next method of separation of the substances is of the winnowing. What is this winnowing? Where we are going to see this process? If you see, this winnowing process is also seen in the agricultural field. Where we are going to see this winnowing? Winnowing is also seen in the agricultural field only. Then what is this winnowing? Okay, after beating of the crop, the grains are separated from the crops, right? That grains are taken to the higher level. Okay, that grains are taken to the higher level, and then they are going to do the winnowing. What is this winnowing means? The crop, the grains are taken in the some of the substance or some of the vessels, and we are going to take into the upper level. With the use of the wind, we are going to push that grains to the ground level. When you are going to leave that crops, leave that grains to the ground level, if any of the dust particle or if any of the mud particles that present in the grains is separated. Winnowing means with the use of the wind, we are going to separate the substances. Then this process we call it as an winnowing. What is winnowing? The method of separation of the substances with the help of the wind. The method of separation of the substances with the help of the wind we call as an winnowing. And I show the third process. What is first one? Hand picking. Second one, threshing. Third one, winnowing. And the last one is sieving. S-I-E-V-I-N-G. Sieving. What is this sieving? This sieving you can see in your home also. If you see your mother, okay, consider that your mother is going to do sieving for the that maida flour, rice flour, wheat flour. Is she going to separate that? If any of the mud particles or if any of the dust particles is present, she going to sieve that flour, okay, that wheat flour, maida flour, any flour. She going to sieve that flour using some of the sieving machines. Maneli jarade anta kelirthira. Okay, did you heard the name of the jarade? They are going to use that jarade to sieve that, to separate if any of the dust particle or any of the mud particles that present in the flour. This is about the sieving. And also the sieving can also be seen where the construction of the building takes place. There also the mud or the soil, what they are going to use for the construction of the building, they are going to sieve that mud. That means they are going to sieving that soil. Why? If any of the rock particles, sand particles is present in that soil, means it get removed from that soil. That why they are going to sieve the soil before the construction of the buildings. Understood the four important methods of separation? What are the four important methods of separation we discussed? We discussed with the four important method of separation. That is, the first one is the hand picking. Next one is threshing. Third, winnowing. And the fourth one is sieving. These are the four important method of separation. After discussing with these four important methods of separations, now we are going to discuss with the important three other methods of separation. That is, this separation, if you see this separation, these separations are of the physical method of separation. We are going to use some physical energy for the separation. But you see, if here this type of separation, we are going to use some of the chemical process also. That we will see one by one. What are the next important method of separations we are going to discuss? The next important method of separation we are going to discuss is, the first one is sedimentation, second one decantation, and the third one filtration. In the filtration only we are going to discuss with the filter paper. Okay, now we will start discussing with one by one. The first thing, what is the first we are going to discuss with? We are going to discuss with the definition of the sedimentation. What is sedimentation? If you see, what is the definition of the sedimentation? When heavier components in a mixture settle after water. What is the definition of the sedimentation? When heavier components in a mixture settles after water. Now we will take the example for this sedimentation process. Consider that you want to take some of the amount of water in the beaker. Okay, for that beaker, now you are going to add some of the sand to it. First, you want to take some amount of water in a beaker. For that beaker, now you are going to add some of the sand to it. What happens? All the sand particles that present in the beaker go and settle to the bottom, right? All the sand particles that present in the beaker go and settle to the bottom. Therefore, the first layer is the water, the next you will get the sand. This process we known as the sedimentation. What is sedimentation? One more time I just tell the definition. What is sedimentation? Whenever the component in the mixture settles after water, that we call it as an sedimentation. Given the example also, when water is reacted with the sand, sand will go at the bottom and water will come in the upper layer. Understood? After sedimentation, now we are going to discuss about the decantation. What is decantation? The decantation is also the one of the method of separation in which the separation of water takes place in this method. In decantation process, the water is separated from the mixture. Example, I said that when you are going to prepare the tea, okay, the tea liquid substance is separated. That is also one of the example for the decantation. Okay, another example, you can give so many examples. Can you give some of the example for the decantation? That is removal of water. After this sedimentation, we are going to remove the water. Okay, the sand is settled at the bottom. We can easily remove the upper part of the water. That also we can call as an decantation. Then what is filtration? Decantation and filtrations are nothing but similar. In the filtration also, we are going to remove the solid particles, solid substances in the one side, and also the liquid substances in the one side. What we are going to do in the filtration? In the filtration, we are going to remove the solid substances in the one side, and also we are going to remove the liquid substances in the one side with the help of filter paper. In the filtration process, what is first of all the filtration? The process of separation of the solid substances and liquid substances with the use of filter paper, that we call it as an filtration. Okay, I will show you exactly how the filter paper is there. Okay, I will show you the video to see how exactly the filter paper is there. What we are going to do here, first we want to take the filter paper. It is just like your tissue paper. Okay, I know you all of you know, see the tissue paper, right? All of you all see the tissue paper. Like similar to the tissue paper, the filter paper is there. What you are going to do first? First, we are going to fold the filter paper in the shape of cone. What we are going to do? We are going to fold the filter paper in the shape of the cone. Then that cone-shaped filter paper is put into the funnel. ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸೀಮೆಣ್ಣೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೋಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತು ತಾನೆ, ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಫನಲ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ದಟ್ ಕೋನ್ ಶೇಪ್ಡ್ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫನಲ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪೋರ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಪೋರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ಆಲ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಪೇಪರ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಟಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅನದರ್ ಬೀಕರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದ ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್? ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಟುಡೇ? ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್, ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪಿಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಥ್ರೆಶಿಂಗ್, ವಿನೋಯಿಂಗ್, ಸೀವಿಂಗ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್, ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್? ವೆನ್ ಹೆವಿಯರ್ ಕಾಂಪೊನೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್ ಸೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸೆಡಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಡಿಕ್ಯಾಂಟೇಷನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ಯಾಂಟೇಷನ್? ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಡಿಕ್ಯಾಂಟೇಷನ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್, ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಪೇಪರ್, ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಪೇಪರ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಓವರ್ಆಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಟುಡೇ. In the next class, we are going to discuss with the some other concept of the separation. I hope that you understand all the concept of the today. Up to that, for the next class, bye everyone, and thank you.